Well, we saw how to differentiate exponentials. Now we need to know, how do we go back the other way? If it's a linear function, so e to the power of some linear function, then all we really need to do is say, oh, well, it'll be 1 over the coefficient of x. And again, the power doesn't change. Of course, that's very limited in its use. Probably what's more useful is using that idea of, remember how we had derivative times, same sort of idea. If we can set it up so that it's derivative times exponential to some function. So we're looking at that. Then we know it must have come from e to the power of that function. We try and set it up so we have the derivative out the front. Now, sometimes we can't with exponentials, but we'll see some techniques in extension 2 integration that allow us then to go and handle those. But consequently, that means in any extension 1 exam, you're probably going to get one where you can do it. Right, so start off with a basic one. E to the 5x, well, it's a linear function. So I can just say, oh, well, that's 1/5 e to the 5x plus, of course, a constant. Mind you, if I did not notice that, then I'd say, oh, okay, let's try and set it up. So I've got derivative times e to the power, and the power is 5x. So I would like 5 e to the 5x. Can't change the question. So I put a fifth out the front. And so then I can integrate and get e to the 5x, and the final answer is, of course, 1/5 e to the 5x. X e to the x squared, so we would like 2x e to the x squared, so we've got a half of that, so that must be a half e to the x squared plus a constant. That's a linear function, so I can just go 1/9, well, that's if I don't recognize it's a linear function, of course. But either way, I get 1/9 e to the 9x minus 5 plus a constant. Square roots of e to the x, well, I'm going to have to change that one into index form. X on 2 is a linear function, so I should be able to do it that way. But again, if I don't recognize it, well, then I'd have a half e to the x on 2, but to balance it out, I'll have 2 out the front. So we end up with 2 e to the x on 2. I always like to leave my answer in the same way they ask the question. So they put the radical symbol in, so I'll put the radical symbol in. Okay, we don't have a product rule, so let's expand the whole thing out and just do each piece individually. And they're all nice linear functions, those powers, so I can just go half e to the 2x minus 2 e to the x minus 3x and plus, of course, a constant. Again, we don't have a quotient rule, but we don't need one for this because we can simplify this one down to be e to the 3x minus e to the minus x. Again, we've got linear functions. So a third e to the 3x plus e to the minus x. Okay, a definite integral. X squared e to the x cubed. So we would like 3x squared. So I've got a third of it. Again, this, just like we were saying the other day, you don't need to put this middle line in. I mean, if you look at it straight away and say, oh, well, look, I've got a third of 3x squared, you can just jump to a third and then do the integration, e to the x cubed. We're subbing in 1, subbing in 0. E to the power of 1 is, of course, e. E to the power of 0 is 1. So we get a third e minus 1. Ah, the base is not e. All right, let's think about this logically. When we were differentiating, if the base was not e, we multiplied by the natural log of the base. We're now going back the other way. So it would seem logical to divide by the natural log of the base. So that'll become 3 to the power of x over the natural log of 3. Okay. Just that big handful again.